Hey, hello. I'm going to give you your weekly overview for week six. This is not even open yet, but I'm just going to go through it really quickly and then I'll open it up for you. So we are starting our new textbook and we're in chapter one. So you'll be reading that chapter. It has a series of articles and you'll be doing a reading reflection assignment that has specific things that I'm looking for from your notes, and then I'm having you, as you read, start to, besides making notes, start to think about all the things that might be great to, as a teacher, have for parents and families. And again, this is not, I say this in the writing of the assignment piece, but I want to emphasize we are not looking for things that parents or guardians or families, whoever the child lives with, are doing wrong, or they should be doing, and we're upset with them for not doing it. We are not looking for those things. We are looking for bridges we can build between home and school that help the child benefit most from practices in the classroom and practices that can be adapted for home. And you'll see in my Padlet that I would love for families to find ways to increase the number of belly laughs in children's lives. And I really mean that. So I'm not just saying that because it was the easiest one to pick. I actually am very concerned about how much joy children are experiencing outside of school and in school. So that's an example from the chapter, from one of the boxes in the chapter, which you'll see. And then I do have a document about science. We're going to start diving into some of these, what we traditionally call content areas, that are really difficult to separate out in early childhood. But because of the way we educate, we are doing this. So, we're going to look at this particular area first because scientific thought is really the foundation of early childhood. It's all the young brain does is engage in scientific thought, basically mess around with things and figure out what happens. So, I'm sure you've all seen different little memes about that that are kind of funny. So, anyway, that's your two big assignments for week six. You've already completed a big assignment, so take a breather. You have two assignments this week. The science assignment will probably take you a little more time than the reading of the chapter, just to give you an idea of the kind of time you're looking at this week in terms of what you're spending your assignment time on. Okay, have a great week.